Hi everyone, my name is Asalton. Welcome back to my dungeon walkthrough. Alright. Now, it's time for the Elite Challenge. Shadow of the ancient evil lay across the land, and every medium of darkness overflows with power. Only a fool would dare to face their masters in hopes of winning the legendary treasures they got. Fool. If we got a fool, I'm amazingly skilled. It's time for the Elite Challenge. So that means the real battle starts now.
We pulled you out from underneath the body of a blue-haired elf and brought you here to the town of Ayrulan. You're to be kept behind bars until we figure out what to do with you.
Let me out of here.
Warden Celia's in charge here, and what's to be done with you is up to her. If I were you, I would keep my head down and learn to be respectful before she finds you making demands.
I don't understand. What is this ring around my neck?
You wear the ring of submission to hold you in check. All prisoners must wear it.
Prisoner, eh?
Hush, here comes the warden now.
Blasted dryads! Quickly, Laura, while she's talking to that elf. Now's your chance.
Foul creature. I warned him what would happen if he attempted to harm a dryad. There can be no hope for these types.
Do not be so hasty, Celia. Some of these prisoners have roles to play yet. I have seen it. This poor soul here, for example, I know this one can be trusted.
I do not know, Amren. Given arms, that mercenary could well kill us all. The entire village is endangered.
As a personal favor to me, please give this prisoner a chance.
As you wish, my friend.
Thank you.
I hope you are able to find that which you seek.
Namare, Melonamin. Till next we meet.
Amren the Elf seems to trust you. I trust only the ring of submission around your neck, prisoner.
Prisoner? Is that what I am now?
Our troops found you on the battlefield. You are lucky they found you alive, unlike the blue-haired elf.
Draven is dead? He must have foreseen this. Where are my things? My medallion?
You were fighting on the side of Valdis. You are an enemy to the Dryads of Ayrulan. Your friend is of no matter to me, and your medallion will remain property of Ayrulan until you show where your loyalties lie.
I have no quarrel with you. I merely follow orders.
It is my orders you will follow now, and you will learn to keep your head down and your mouth shut. I have a task for you.
What do you want me to do?
Go to the weaponsmith at the blacksmith shop. She has spared some sharpening stones for our warriors. Get them. And take them to the Dryad outpost just outside the north gate of town.
Very well. With this ring around my neck, I suppose I don't have much of a chance.
Be thankful Amren spoke up for you. Take my advice, prisoner, and avoid the animals of the jungle. One bite from them, and you'll be riddled with the plague. Now go, and don't make me regret granting Amren's favor.
Thank you.
Yeah.
just some minutes, and then we will be on 6th.
Be one of Celia's. You wear the ring of submission around your neck.
True. I need the warden's sharpening stones right away.
Here you are. And if you have some time, perhaps you could do a favor for me?
A long way to prove I am no longer your enemy. What might I do?
With all the fighting, we go through armor faster than we can craft it. Duma and Sen both need my help throughout the day and into the night. But I've only been in this trade for a short number of months. There's much to remember.
I am in a hurry, but how can I help?
There is a tome of smithing within the Great Hall that is sure to contain such information. I would be in your debt if you can discover the steps to creating Dryad armor.
That hardly seems difficult. I will turn the shortly.
What are you doing out of the prison ward? You should not be wandering around here.
I was wondering if I could purchase some of your goods. Let's see. Not bad. Wait a second. I don't know. It's a very hard decision. No. I don't know. And this? I see.
Have you discovered the steps for crafting that armor? Duma has been giving me the looks. I'm afraid she has realized that I've forgotten one of the most important crafting recipes.
Aye. Listen closely and I shall tell you.
That is good news indeed. If I don't get started soon, I'll never be done in time. Dryad armor is tricky stuff to make on a forge. Quietly now, tell me what the tome said.
Use 5 squanders of leather, 3 pots of boiling wax, 12 stone shroom discs, and 2 baskets of leaves. Coat the leather with wax, apply the discs, then fasten the leaves to the resulting armor.
That rings true. Please wait a moment while I make the armor.
Very well. I am quite curious, to be honest.
Excuse me, Craftmaster Sen. The Dryad armor is completed, just as you requested.
This is indeed fine work, Telenu. Excellent. You may keep that suit for yourself as a reward for a job well done.
Good.
My thanks. Craftmaster Sen seemed almost happy with my work for once. And it's thanks to your sleuthing. Please, take this armor as a gift for your assistance.
Thank you, Telenu. I am glad I was able to... But it's a shit.
Well, prisoner. I suppose I can enchant an item for you so long as that ring ensures your good behavior. If you are able to pay my price, I may be able to make you something very special.
Tell me more about this special thing.
First, you must understand that becoming a master enchantress is not easy. One must spend many years studying the arts of herbalism and alchemy. If one did not know the properties of every reagent and the results of their combination, why, terrible things could happen. I have even seen careless apprentices blow themselves up.
It sounds like a difficult art to master.
For one of my caliber, even the most difficult of tinctures and salves are possible. There is one in particular that is my specialty. It grants a fair amount of life recovery. I am told it is quite useful if you are interested.
Oh, that does sound rather useful. Tell me more.
My customers call it Lumilla's salve, and it can be applied to enchantable armor for fighters and rangers, or jewelry of your preference. I would be happy to make some if you bring me the ingredients. 4 nettle clusters. They can be found in the jungle, if you keep your eyes open.
Thank you. I will be on the lookout for nettle clusters. One mission is complete.
My story is both long and sad. You'll probably want to sit down and take out a hanky. And many years ago, I was captain of a fine ship. Now,
Yes, but now what?
Oh, well, one day, my ship was wrecked in a brutal storm. I was washed ashore, unconscious. When I came to...
When you came to, what happened then?
Right. As I was saying, when I came to, there was a beautiful woman standing over me. There was something a little odd about her, though.
What was odd about her?
Ah, you'll never believe this part. This is the part no one ever believes. As I was saying, there was this beautiful woman, and she was...
Beautiful woman, yes, yes?
Well, she was green. Green and leafy. I had seen many strange things in my time, but none so strange as that, let me tell you. Well, except maybe for the...
What? For the what?
Well, you see, when I was your age... Before I was captain of that ship, of course, I was a soldier. I was stationed at Windstone Fortress, which was built by the ancient Azenites way back before the... What was I talking about again?
Something strange you had seen. What was it?
Oh, of course. As I was saying, my job was to sweep the cloister in the Temple of Xeria at the heart of the fortress. So one day I was sweeping and I stubbed my toe. You'll never guess what I stubbed it on.
A senile man, perhaps?
We wouldn't have let senile old men into the temple, no. It was a green stone carved with the ancient Azenite symbol of the Tree of Life. There was a socket in the center of the room that looked as if the stone would fit inside it. But I took a nap instead of trying it. I bet if I had, though, it would have opened a secret door or something. There, now, Wasn't that riveting?
Yes, yes. Tell me more about that song.
I believe it may be part of some sort of puzzle. You know, they were keen on that sort of thing back in the temple's heyday. If you could investigate that for me, it would put my mind at rest.
It sounds intriguing, I must admit. Very well.
Thank you, friend. The Temple of Xeria can be found deep within Windstone Fortress.
Okay, it's time for the sixth member.
The battle has brought so many travelers. I can hardly find beds for them all. This inn is the crossroads of the island. If you ever lose a friend, chances are they'll end up here. The Warriors Guild Pack states that adventurers of sufficient standing may add a sixth seat to their party roster, but they must be charged a one-time fee for it. Do you wish to add a sixth seat to your party? Congratulations! You may now have up to six members in your party. Would you like to see what adventurers are available? The battle has brought so many travelers. Very sorry, but the Warriors Guild Pack states that six is the maximum party size any adventurer may have.
As you can see, not eight. Back on Dungeon Siege. But that should be enough.
The battle has brought so many.
Let's see. Who could that be? No. To be certain, but I don't think so. Or Vex. It's a hard choice. Either way.
I spent enough time rotting away seeking in my arse, but...
Are you kidding me? Off limit. Are you kidding me? Thought it would work. But now?
Yes, we're rather busy, so make it quick, prisoner.
Can I see what you have for sale? 50 strength? Oh my gosh. Interesting. Wait.
You must have been roughed up pretty badly out there if you think I'm going to sell you anything. Well, I do have a few things I was going to throw away. You can look them over if you don't have anything better to do.
I suppose I don't. Show me what you got. I don't think so. Incredible! I'm more powerful. That's a shit.
Whatever errands the warden is having you run must be dangerous. I might have a few potions left I can part with.
Any help is welcome. Let's see. Bad. I don't think so.
You are clear to leave.
Last, I've escaped that dreary tree town. Finally on my way. Freedom, glory, adventure!
Danger, pain, death.
I see. You're gonna try to explain to me that I don't know what I'm getting into.
Something like that.
What's the matter? Were there lies in your porridge this morning? Your attitude could sour milk.
I know what lies ahead. I have no grand illusions. We go to greet the Morden.
Morden? I've heard they're practically savages. I wonder if it's true they eat their own dead right on the battlefield.
Oh, yes. They have a regular picnic.
Tell me more. Have you seen them in the act?
It is time for me to stop talking.
There you are, prisoner. Come along. I am to take you to the outpost. It is just ahead.
Colossal. Incredible. As you can see, 75. 75? What? Only 62. All of them are shit. Interesting, but not good enough for me. cool looks.
Respite was my thought when I saw this place. I first glimpsed it through the underbrush. Deserted, we thought. A fine place to set up camp. But then, in the black of night, we heard the drums and saw the torchlight. I saw across the way a lever, certainly to activate the bridge. But on this side, there was nothing. And it was here that I met my violent fate.
Terrible indeed, but trust that it will be away. I will get to follow this for you. Rest in peace.
That is all my weary soul needs, to hear uttered those words of release. Thank you, my friend.
Farewell, Spade. Good travels to you. Well done. We are the elite commandos. Everything is possible now. You all deserve to die. Die, motherfucker!
We're free! Thank
you.
Kirani? What happened here?
Celia, what a surprise to see you here. Look, the prisoner just saved us.
I came here to make sure this one followed my orders. Saved you? How is it I see the escort I sent lying here dead?
Don't be too harsh, Celia. Jera was overwhelmed. There was nothing the prisoner could have done to save her.
Good witness.
Too harsh? There is no such thing. Not for one who murdered our people and defiled our shrine.
I have looked into this one's eyes, sister. All I see is a haunting remorse. We are not the only ones who have lost souls dear to us in this war. This prisoner saved our lives.
Is it true what Kirani says? Did you defeat those Morden?
I am no friend to the Morden. I never was. I wish only to return to my hometown.
Some of the sisters seem to think that you deserve your freedom. I don't think so highly of you. But perhaps I could be yet convinced.
Tell me what I need to do.
The Morden know we've suffered a devastating blow. They smell blood. Kirani tells me they are erecting towers around this village and taking over all of our outposts.
It's only a matter of time before they lay siege to our homes and destroy us all. Valdis plans to march to power over the bones of our people.
Burn those towers to the ground, and you'll save our lives. And yours.
Consider it done.
I'll consider it done when I see the smoke in the air.
Here's the outpost gate key and some basic gear.
And here is the stone that will allow you to use the teleporters to return to Aiyalon. Do well, and I'll consider granting you your freedom. I might even give you back your gear and that cheap medallion.
That medallion is important to me. Belong to my only true friend.
So it seems you hold dear things other than a sack of coins. You are more than meets the eye, prisoner. Good luck.
See that those towers fall. Every last one of them.
Come, Kirani. We must return to the prisoner ward. We have much to discuss.
Advance to free the Morden towers. Wait a second. Let's continue. level 6. Should be enough. That's a better idea. My name is not your concern.
Worm! You do not tell me what is or is not my concern.
I should tell you what the way I was overgrown first.
I'll pick my teeth with your ribcage before I'm through with you. I'll suck the marrow from your bones. Ah!
Fuck you.
You don't seem to like the Morden any more than me.
Thank you. If we just killed the Morden guards, we could leave the towers standing. Those towers are fine structures. Shame to waste them. Yes, well, when you put it that way.
Died by nightfall had you not arrived. You have my thanks, stranger. Who are you?
A prisoner of your people. A monster of what?
You? A follower of Valdis? I cannot believe that a servant of that merciless tyrant would have acted so bravely.
I am his servant no longer. I have seen what is true, his true colors. It is now my pleasure to dispatch them more than anybody I can, as long as they stand between me and my homeland.
Valdis is driving his forces hard. I overheard the Morden complaining of his ruthless demands. He never tires, never rests, and he expects the same from his servants.
Valdis will get what's coming to him. Now, how do I burn this tower to the ground?
It hasn't rained in a while. The wood's sure to be dry. If you could make a torch, it would burn beautifully. But watch out. I saw them loading explosives inside.
It will only take a moment. No way! Burn! Burn, Morden! You all deserve it.
Creatures is my joy. I only hope I don't get too happy.
You just... You can't hold on. Thank you.
kidnapped Tansy! Tell me where she is or I will kill you, fiend!
Ah, I'll kill you first, green lady!
Close. Too late even for a Haku.
Him, the little imp. Tansy will surely die now.
Tansy?
They nearly killed Hesla as well, but I was able to bring her safely back to Ireulon. But Tansy, oh, I could not reach her in time. Tansy is my niece. We three, Tansy, my sister Hesla, and I, were searching for survivors following the Morden attacks. Tansy was taken by the treacherous Haku.
The Haku? Those little masked forest creatures?
Yes! They are vile fiends! The caves nearby have long been a Haku stronghold, and gladly did we allow them to remain, even though they did occasionally cause mischief. We should have exterminated them when we had the chance! Oh, poor Tansy!
Aye, well, war does indeed reveal one's true colors. I'm sorry about your niece.
Please, stranger, you seem able and well-equipped. Help me find Tansy! I am wounded seriously. I do not think I can continue the search. Tansy will be done for if she is not rescued soon.
Certainly, lady. I shall get to the bottom of this.
Oh, bless you, friend. I am sure they cannot have taken Tansy far. There is a vast network of caves within these cliffs. I recall coming across another entrance once, in the dark jungle between this bridge and the next. I was headed there when that horrible vermin ambushed me.
I will do my best to find it, lady. Now take yourself back to Ireland. Those wounds look deep.
My prayers will be with you, friend. I will make my way back to town and join my sister in the infirmary. Please hurry. Tansy must be terribly frightened.
Not that way. Thank you. good.
Have you lost your tongue?
Nothing to say.
Well, this is going to be an awfully long journey if we must endure your power.
No longer than putting up with your pointless chatter.
Hey, great leader! Why did you ask this wet rag to join us?
Be quiet. The next Morden Tower lies ahead.
So it does. Those Morden will rue the day I joined this group.
I can think of one half-giant who already does.
No, 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 no. Don't you dare.
You almost killed yourself.
Trunk will
flowing water is life to the dryad body, and still water is peace to the dryad soul. I tend this sacred place for the forest sisters, and guard its contents. If you be a friend of the wood, enter and partake of whatever you may find. If you be an enemy, know that you will be cursed if you lay your hands to anything in this place. What say you?
Many thanks, Spirit. I am indeed the friend of the wood.
Then I have done what I have been tasked to do. I may move on now.
Seven.
good. You all deserve it. be stronger than that.
In this place once, long, long ago. This city was a place of true beauty. They welcomed us here as true sylvan folk, but our desire was to live high in the trees. Now all is but a memory, and that memory fades with time. That beyond the wall is home now only to creatures of the wood, the dark souls that hide from the sun's light. Step carefully, traveler. The dark shadows hide things. Deadly things.
I will make the land beyond the wall a safe place, but there's much that must be said.
Thank you. My time of guardianship is then ended. I may at last return to the shining shores in peace. Fare thee well, mortal.
Just do it, whatever the cost. Ai, mamma mia!
You, did you see that? Haran could not have been lying, else why would he have come to my defense like that? I thank you for arriving when you did, stranger. This place is not safe for us to linger. Let us return to Irulan before the other Haku return in force.
All right. Finish this.
Doing out of the prison ward.
Very well done. Sorry, but I'm too tired to continue. So, subscribe to my channel, click on the like button, and we continue next time. Bye bye.